Dear learners, greetings of the day. I am Dr. Nupma Sangwan, Assistant Professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar. In today's session, we'll try to explore the concept of information communication technology, digital divide, digital native, and digital immigrants. This module will focus on the types of digital literacy along with some common misconceptions prevailing about digital literacy. Many of you will agree that with the advent of 21st century, numerous opportunities have opened their doors for the teachers in constructing educational experiences in more fruitful and enjoyable way. If you look at recent scenario, then you will observe that present day classrooms are very distinct from what we have seen in our school days. These changes are the result of technological advancement. The computer technology has grown by leaps and bounds over the past half century. The amount of progress that it has taken in computer technology over the past couple of decades is quite staggering and totally unprecedented in any other area. In previous module, we have learned that every teacher is required to learn how and when to use technology for achieving excellence and improvement in teaching. It is a well-known fact that technology has remained instrumental in making teaching and learning more efficient and effective. Teachers are building digital literacy skills to nurture their own competencies in order to adapt with changing scenarios. So, before moving further, let us first have a look at the learning outcomes of this session. After completing this module, you will be familiar with the concepts of information communication technology and other related terms. You will gain more insight of the concept digital literacy and its types. You will also understand the role of digital literacy in improving teachers' competencies. Moreover, this module will be a great help in unfolding common misconceptions about digital literacy. There are number of factors which are associated with the qualities of a good teacher. But nowadays, a new notion is on everyone's tongue, that is digital literacy. It is the ability to use digital devices effectively for collaboration, expression, and communication over internet and social media. Digital literacy is gaining importance these days as the world is shrinking in terms of time and space. Before understanding the concept of digital literacy in detail, let's understand few key terms which are closely related with the concept of digital literacy and often create confusion. These terms are information technology, information and communication technology, digital native, digital immigrants, and digital divide. So let's dive in and discuss these terms one by one. Information technology and information communication technology. IT and ICT are sometimes used interchangeably as they are closely related with each other. Information communication technology is the extension of term information technology and has addition of one more acronym, communication, which signifies the whole difference between these two. Information technology generally refers to the whole industry which uses computer, network, and other softwares for storing and sharing data or information. On the other hand, the term ICT includes other communication devices like radio, television, smartphone, along with the computer for receiving, storing, retrieving, manipulating, and transmitting information digitally. It is commonly used in academic arena and generally described as one of the specialized branch of information technology. Digital native and digital immigrants are commonly used terms these days. Now, let's understand the difference between these two terms. Digital native or digital immigrants are the two labels which are used for indicating people of different generations. The term digital native is used for those who took birth after 1980s and are more comfortable with the use of technology. On the other hand, people who are born before 1980s are referred as digital immigrants. They have fear for technology and find it more challenging because they are exposed to technology in later years of their life. They usually avoid technology uses and show more resistance in its adoption in various walks of their life. Next one is the digital divide. It means the difference and the gap that exists between people of developed and developing countries in terms of access, use of information, especially in the area of information communication technology. This generally happens due to economic disparities between different countries across the world. Developing country citizens may have limited knowledge and skill because of insufficient and restricted access of ICT, which is ultimately result in digital divide. Now, after understanding these key terms, we will move to the concept of digital literacy. The word literacy means ability to read and write. However, when word digital is added next to it, then the term digital literacy encompasses much broader range of skills. Digital literacy is the ability of an individual to understand, navigate, and communicate through various platforms. American Library Association defined digital literacy as, it is the ability to use information and communication technologies to find, evaluate, create, and communicate information, requiring both cognitive and technical skills. It includes the understanding of uses of wide range of digital technology for searching, retrieving, and utilizing information. Spies and Bartlett in the year 2012 categorized digital literacy in three buckets. These are finding and consuming the digital content. Second is the creating digital content and communicating and sharing it. A digitally literate person is able to search, find, compose, analyze, and evaluate the information retrieved from different digital platforms. Some of the characteristics of digitally literate person are understanding the use of search engines, emails, wikis, blogs, web browsers, PowerPoint, ability to create videos, and knowledge of different educational softwares. In the next part of this module, we will have a look at different types of digital skills. Eshet in 2004 identified five types of digital literacy. The first type is photovisual literacy. The skill is concerned with the ability to read, understand, comprehend, and figure out the information retrieved from visuals. It is the responsiveness towards visual clues and multimedia text for practical uses. It involves understanding and making association between information presented visually. The next is reproduction literacy. It is the capability of an individual to produce, create meaningful and authentic work by using and collecting separate pieces of independent information in a creative way. The next is branching literacy. Branching literacy is the ability of successful navigating over the internet in non-linear pattern. This is done in order to gain information from different sources in the digital space without following line-by-line reading. This helps in collecting maximum amount of information without compromising much time. Here, the user utilizes wide range of options provided by digital media, which provides freedom of navigation. The fourth type of digital literacy is information literacy. It is one of the most important survival skills in this digital age. As a user is exposed to a lot of information, and extracting right information out of vast literature is a challenging task. In simpler terms, it is ability of identifying, locating, and evaluating information found on the internet for effective and productive use in solving problems at hand. The next one is the socio-emotional literacy. Seeing the security concerns, practice of communication, socialization, and collaboration using digital media has introduced new challenges of managing interaction with others. Here comes the role of social and emotional literacy, which prepares a user in identifying traps and dealing with cyberspace security issues. Till now, we have understood about the concept of digital literacy and its type. Let us now get acquainted with different types of digital literacy skills required by teachers. Since 1980s, when the personal computers were introduced in our lives, the wave of digitalization has started. And now it has grown up into tsunami with the arrival of internet and smartphones. This wave of digitalization has demanded renewal and expansion of teachers' competencies, especially digital competencies. Several teachers as well as students are already using digital tools for different reasons. But this does not mean that they can use the same tool for teaching and learning effectively. Learning technology is a perennial process which demands continuous learning and practice. It involves a lot of trial and error in the path of gaining mastery. There are many digital skills which are helpful for teachers and students in utilizing technology efficiently and productively. First and the foremost is the ability to search effectively. One must know how to navigate search engines in order to find relevant and secure information. Next is the ability to evaluate retrieved information and sources. A teacher must possess the ability to differentiate between authentic and unlawful websites and web sources. The information must be evaluated in terms of its accuracy and reliability. The third one is critical thinking and creativity. A teacher should have a deeper understanding of different available digital tools and must be able to use them in inculcating creativity among the students. The fourth one is the communication and collaboration. Teacher must be able to communicate and collaborate with students and other teachers across the world in order to coordinate his projects and develop professionally. Next in the list is knowledge of chat and PLN platforms. This is very important as the tools like Skype, Google Hangouts provides platform for students to talk, chat and interact with experts and their mentors. Personal learning network is another way of growing network and connecting with people of same interest. The next in the list is ability to avoid copyright issues and citing others' work properly. With the growing access of information, transparency in using others' work has become very important, as various issues like copyright infringement may arise if someone's work is not cited properly. So, one must learn to cite properly and give credit to someone's work to the original author in order to avoid any issue at later stage. Further, it is very important to learn how to behave like a good digital citizen and value others' ideas and opinion, because web is a big place and where many people interact virtually. Next important digital skill is recognizing digital footprints. Digital footprint is a digital information of a person about his internet activities which is available online. Whenever we create any profile or post something publicly and do any activity via internet, it will be viewable to everybody. So, it must be ensured that our footprints do not harm our reputation. Last but not the least, very important skill that one needs to be mastered is maintaining privacy. Information can be shared in number of ways on the web, and one should learn about security and internet safety basics. We must learn to create strong passwords, as internet is one of the insecure places of losing personal information. It is important to mention that the contribution of digitalization is not acknowledged by many of us. One of the reasons behind technology resistance is the prevalence of many misapprehensions about its use among people. Certainly, many of you must have heard various misconceptions and myths about digital literacy. Some of these misconceptions are more prevalent than others. Although these beliefs are difficult to eradicate completely, as they are very deeply rooted across the world and in our society particularly. Let us unveil some of these common myths by knowing the reality behind them and learn some more facts that can enable us in becoming more techno-savvy. A digitally literate teacher knows all about technology. it is true that digitally literate teacher should be efficient enough in choosing accurate and reliable technology which is appropriate and suitable for their classrooms. He must be able to use technology and provide guidance for nurturing students' creativity and critical understanding. But believing that he knows everything is not just, as technology is not constant, nor is the digital literacy. Hence, no one can be master of everything. The second myth is technology is great and everything. It must be clear in everybody's mind that technology itself cannot transform learning. In fact, no technology has significance if the teacher don't understand how to utilize it. Although technology connect many students with numerous resources, but technology integration in the classroom is not possible without the involvement of the teacher. Certainly, technology has changed teachers' role but cannot replace his human connection and influence on the students. The next myth is digital literacy is the opponent of traditional teaching methods. This is also a strong belief or a misconception among people that technology works in contrast with traditional teaching methods. The reality is actually contrary to this belief, because different educational technologies have strong foundation in traditional pedagogical principles. Technologies simply empowers a teacher in making teaching to the advanced stage of upgrading pedagogical approaches and do not replace traditional approaches. Therefore, one must learn to adapt and incorporate the best of both worlds. Further, many of us think digital literacy is special and a earmark skill. It is another strong misconception about digital literacy where we think that it should be taught as a separate skill. However, if we separate technology from specific learning context, it will limit the learner's conception about its potential of shaping teaching and learning. In fact, in every learning context, there should be a digital component in the form of instructional strategy, feedback, and assignment. Another wrong opinion is that digital natives are by birth digitally literate. It is commonly believed that learners of 21st century are digital natives. Therefore, they are digitally literate. But it has been observed that they mostly use technology for fun and are only good at using technology on the social platform for chatting, interacting with friends. They are not equally good at using technology for their academic purposes and need proper guidance and training when technology is used in formal teaching environment. Technology turn student impassive is the next misconception that people carry with them. By and large, it is believed that in technology-enabled classrooms, students remain stuck to their computer screens. They passively watch videos and lack interaction and connection with others. In this sense, technology is completely mistaken, because effective integration of technology in classroom, it is essential that learners should remain active throughout the process of learning and teaching. Moving ahead, the next myth is, it is mandatory for a teacher to be technology expert for utilizing digital skills in his teaching endeavors. Teachers often think that as they are not technology expert, hence cannot use technology in their classrooms. But this is completely wrong way of approaching things, and no one is expert of technology, as technology need to be learned and practiced continuously. The next misconception is that technology learning requires good amount of time. Teachers usually grumble about their direct teaching load and other academic and administrative duties in their institutions. Further, non-availability of adequate infrastructure and shortage of time act as a deterrent for skill attainment. Undoubtedly, it is true that learning of any new skill takes a lot of time and effort. Still, we do it correctly and learn patiently. In the end, it saves our time and automates many tasks like assessment and evaluation. Last in the list is use of mobile phone by student may create confusion and distraction. Many parents and teachers strongly believe that use of mobile phones by the students is the biggest reason for distraction and time wastage. On the other hand, smartphones are powerful and resilient tool of 21st century pedagogy. As and when students require any type of information, they can use mobile phones as encyclopedia and get the easy access of whatever they need. A meticulous, hardworking, and innovative teacher can easily manage his classroom with students carrying their smartphones with them and will be able to take advantage of their devices without letting them get distracted. In a nutshell, we can say that technology integration must not be seen as opponent of traditional approaches of teaching. A teacher must learn to maintain a balance between traditional methods of teaching and ICT integration. It is very important for each one of us to be digitally literate in this techno-savvy culture. Before winding up this session, let us have a look at what we have discussed so far. We have discussed about the concepts and types of digital literacy. Besides this, we have learnt about various digital literacy skills such as searching effectively, protecting your private information online, giving proper credit to others' work, and accessing internet securely. In the end, we have unfolded various misconceptions associated with digital literacy and technology integration. This concludes our today's session. Thank you for staying with us.